joining us in this program. Amen. Believe me. And I want you to put yourself. I want you to be prepared, because you're going to have an encounter that you have never had before.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Please, I want us to pray. Amen. I want us to pray. I just want us to pray. When I was coming, God gave me a word for you people. Can you break open your Bible to the book of Psalms 38? Psalms 35, please. 35 from verse 1. If you are there, you can read. Pardon me.
Psalms 35.
Yes.
Plead my cause, O Lord, with them that strive with me. Fight against them that fight against me.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Leave it there. When you go back home, you can continue. Amen.
Amen.
I came to speak a word. I came to pray with you because God told me that any voice that wants to rise against this praying daughter, that voice will be silenced.
Amen.
I don't care to know who is opposing this vision in the realm of the spirit and in the physical. The one thing I know is that God has spoken. And after today, any other voice that wants to speak, that voice will be silenced.
Yeah.
Is somebody getting me?
Yes, ma'am.
And if God is speaking, He is speaking to you. You who is praying, there are voices that are speaking against you. You know, a despised person cannot pray. A confused woman cannot pray. A depressed woman cannot pray. A woman who is not satisfied cannot pray. Are you getting me? But I want to announce to somebody that today, I don't care to know what has been opposing you. Today, God will oppose that person. Hallelujah. Our Lord God was talking about the life of Esther. There were many things that were standing as challenge to her. But she rose up as a woman of valor. She rose up as an outstanding woman in her own time. And she became a voice up to now. We are celebrating because Esther stood for her nation. I want to celebrate God with you. Praying for us. Hallelujah. If every daughter in all the commissions in this universe can pick up something like this, I think, servant of God, our nation will get revival. Hello? If you see where women gather to pray, things begin to happen. Because we are the last born of God.
Hey.
Hello? So today, I came to pray with you. Wherever you are, rise up on your feet. We are going to do just one prayer. Just one. Amen?
Amen.
Any power, any voice that has been speaking in the realm of the spirit, contrary to this vision, today, we join our voices together and silence the voice. Because this vision is going internationally. Is somebody understanding me? This vision cannot stop here. We cannot keep on having the same faces all the time. If there is progress, we will see more faces every day. Are you getting me? So we are going to pray and say, Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
Say, my Father, my Father. In the realm of the spirit,
and in the physical,
that has been speaking against praying daughters. Today we silence you. Praying daughters, open your mind and pray. Lango shakara bala 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 bala. Iku bako bako. Lika bala bala. to become influential women. Hallelujah. Yeah. If all of us can catch this vision and run with it, I promise you, next time, we are not going to have space. For us to have increase, for us to see progress, we need to be influential. Is somebody understanding me? You cannot influence people when you yourself, you are not capable. It is only a capable person that can talk to an undefined person. Hello? So you need to carry capacity. You need to be a woman of words. When you appear, things bow. When you appear, environment automatically changes. Hallelujah. Oh, I see women in this place who are going to be voices in this generation. You know, we have voice, but there are voice. When you hear a voice, you will understand that this voice is different. Hello? Last week I was in Douala, I was talking to one man. When I went there, I went, my husband sent me to collect something. I called her on phone. She had never seen me before. When I called him on phone, he said, "Hey, I perceive this is a great voice talking to me. I salute you, man. On phone, sir. I've never met him before." When I went there, when I entered the place, he looked at me and he said, "Woman, you carry something. Amen. I don't know you, I've never seen you. Only your voice speaks. I prophesy to somebody to be here. Your voice will cause you to be attacked. I pray your voice will cause you to be attacked. In the name of Jesus." Esther's voice was the voice that carried substance. I promise you, if your voice carries substance, when you see something, people will catch it and run with it. But if you are just making noise, nobody will find the vision. If my daughter was just making noise, he will not see this great man here. He will not see me here.
Yes.
Are you understanding? He will not see great men and women who are here. It's because her voice carries something. This time next year, some of you will be sitting comfortably in a box. I hear God telling me to talk to you. I'm seeing you as an international figure. I don't know you. But when I was seated there, God told me to speak to you. That you are an international figure. I don't know what has been keeping you all these years. But after this anniversary, there is going to be an opening. It will happen like a dream. Thank you, Jesus. Change your story. Let there be a divine connection. 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 Somebody shall I receive. Somebody shall I receive. Hallelujah. Whatever you are, lift up your hands now. Close your eyes. Father, I bring your daughters before you. Your son has ministered. Your power has come. Transformation has taken place. Deliverance has taken place. Marriage has been restored. Yes, 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 Lord. Oh. shout amen. Somebody shout amen. My father, my maker, I bless your daughters and your son who are present here. That after this encounter, that foundational problem that has been keeping them down for years, by the reason of this anniversary, those foundations are broken in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said they are destroyed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There is a rebuild of destiny now. God is rebuilding your destiny. Thank you, Jesus. Your cheers is being turned to celebration.
Amen.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you, Father. With your hands, I just worship God for 1 minute. Yes, you are the Lord. Can you worship God?
Yes, you are.
We have the green color and we also have the red color. Praise the Lord.
I'm going to start with the dominant color. The dominant color here is the color white. Amen. And white stands for purity. Praise God. As we're entering the second year as praying daughters, after 1 year, we are called upon to live a life of purity. Praise the Lord. Little things matter. Don't say that, no, those little things, I don't care. As our papa has preached and from our mama, we are called upon to live a life that will be an example to others in Jesus' name. We should be able to influence and affect our generation in the mighty name of Jesus. The next dominant color is the color orange. Hallelujah. Orange stands for happiness. Celebrate yourselves because we are going back happy. Peace be chill. We are going back happy in Jesus' name. Orange stands for sunshine. There is a shining blessing that will locate us after now in Jesus' name. Because we came here today, because we are under this God, because we are going to eat this cake today, you're going back with a greater light in Jesus' name. We'll be shining in our career, shining in our spiritual life, our ministries, in our businesses, wherever we go, we're going to shine in Jesus' name. Orange also stands for creativity. Hallelujah. There is a praying daughter that will eat this cake, and there is a new business idea that will come upon you in Jesus' name. There is a praying daughter that will take this cake. There is another dimension of ministry that the Lord is going to give to you in Jesus' name. There is a way a praying daughter will handle that marriage, that the husband will say, hey, is this my wife? There is a creativity entering your marriage in Jesus' name. Even in the domain of cooking foods, that food that you used to cook, that fufu and ero that you used to present to your husband, there is a creativity in how to present that fufu and ero now, and your marriage will be blessed in Jesus' name. And last but not the least, we have the color yellow. Praise God. Yellow stands for the light of God. It stands for brightness. Hallelujah. As we taste this cake, the light of God will continuously be shining over us in Jesus' name. And after that, we have the color green. Green means freshness. Hallelujah. There is a fresh fire coming upon a praying daughter, upon a praying man in the house. There is a fresh fire, a fresh encounter in the name of Jesus. As a praying daughter, our lives are not ordinary. Because we came here today, because we are going to stay this day, because we are under prophetic anointing, because we are under prophetic grace this morning. Hallelujah. We are going back with some freshness in Jesus' name. We are going fresh in Jesus' name. And finally, there is a color red somewhere. Praise the Lord. Can we put our hands together for Jesus? Can we celebrate Jesus, somebody? Hallelujah. The color red stands for the blood of Jesus. The price he paid on the cross of Calvary for us to have salvation. So we are going back blessed because we have salvation as a result of the blood of Jesus. Celebrate Jesus once more. Praise the Lord. Right away, we are going properly to the unveiling of the cake. Hallelujah. So before we unveil this cake, I will call upon our mama to give us some dimension, because I'm not capable, I don't have the capacity to talk on the unveiling of this double portion that will give us today. Hallelujah. Celebrate that, somebody.
Hallelujah. Honestly, I didn't plan for this, but I am led to do it as she has said I should do it. Amen. Please, can somebody help me unveil this cake? Thank you. There are a lot of mysteries hidden inside of us as praying daughters. As I unveil this cake, God is going to unveil that thing in your life. And this is prophetic right now. I said there are a lot of mysteries embedded inside of you. As I unveil this cake, God is going to unveil it. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. And I also decree that there shall be self-discovery after now. Amen. Many of us have not understood who we are and where we are going. But by the reason of the unveiling of this cake, God shall begin to reveal yourself to you. There is one thing for God to reveal people to you. The one I'm talking about now is that God is going to reveal you to you. I will be living to hear a better amen. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Wow, what a beautiful cake. What a beautiful gift. Pastor Olive has done the presentation already of the different colors and what they stand for. Amen. Father, thank you for this, that you have set a table before us as we eat of this cake, Lord. Let our lives become sweet. Let our lives become better. Lord, as we eat from this table, I pray and I decree that we shall not lack any good thing after now. In the name of Jesus, I declare this table blessed and sanctified in Jesus' name. We are going to have the cutting of the cake right now. And I want to call on my mother present in the house, and Papa Eta, and Mama Jemene Eta. They are going to support me as I cut this cake. My hand cannot go down alone. If it's about me, I cannot run this vision. There are people that God has placed in my life as a strong support. And so as I'll be cutting the cake, I want their hands to be added to mine. I also want to celebrate God for my father, he's not yet, the Apostle of Healing, Apostle Solidania. Please celebrate God for him. Celebrate God for him. Celebrate God for him. I know he's still watching, but he knows we have an event like this. Amen. Please, Mama. Daddy, Mama. Please, can you take the mic? We're about to cut our cake. Can we watch the authority standing behind this cake? The prophetic cake is being headed by our own mama, Pastor Naomi Pleasant. We have our grandmother, Mama Damian. We have Prophet Eta Peter and the beautiful wife. Right now, they are going to cut the cake and we're going to start with the name J. When we call the energy of the cutting, give me a J. Because we are going to eat the cake now. Not so, Mama. We are eating now. On our tables, everybody has a paper napkin. So we are going to cut. I don't know. And then share.
This is it.
Can somebody help me? I have a gift for us, which is a souvenir. It's been prayed upon. So we are just going to share it to us. It's a mantle for this mandate we are going with. Amen. One thing that is so particular about praying daughter is that we function or operate under the covenant of preservation. And I pray, as you go with this mantle, let God walk with you.
Amen.
Let God go with you.
Amen.
Let God be seen in you.
Amen.
Let God be seen with you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. We're just going to share it. Everybody is supposed to have one. Please come and help me. You share to everybody. Can we have another praying daughter? So we do it quick, very fast. It's a mantle, it's not the same. My mother is in the house, my biological mother. Please, can we celebrate her?
Hallelujah.
Celebrate her. Christ. Amen. She labored in a place of prayer for me to become born again. I thank God for her.
Thank you.